Welcome to Ultra Health Tutorial. In the last class, we discussed flagellates, giardia, and trichomonas. And in this, we will discuss hemoflagellate, trypanosoma. Before coming to trypanosoma, let's discuss the four morphological forms of these hemoflagellates, which are divided according to their position of flagellum. The first one is the amastigot. Amastigot meaning A is absent, and mastigot is the two word mastix, is derived from mastic. So absence of flagella is a amastigot form. It is a non-motile and it is always intracellular form. Then there is a promastigot. The meaning of pro is before the nuclei. Pro, pehle nuclei se. So they have the anterior flagellates with the central nucleus, and these are the elongated one, lanceolate shape. Then there is the epimastigot. In this epimastigot, the flagellum arises from lateral side of this mastigot form, and it forms a short undulating membrane, and flagella will arise from anterior end. And the last one is the trypomastigot. In this, the flagella starts arising from the posterior as an undulating membrane and come out of its body from the anterior end. So, amastigot, promastigot, epimastigot, and trypomastigot. Always remember, the fourth one is the trypomastigot, not trypanomastigot. Trypanosoma is a parasite, and the stage one, that is the trypomastigot. Shape we already discussed. Amastigot, it is always intracellular form, present both in leishmania and trypanosoma. In hemoflagellates, we discussed the two parasites, leishmania and the trypanosoma. In this lecture, we will discuss only trypanosoma. And promastigot is an infective stage to man, which is present in the insect vector sandfly. Epimastigot, this is found in man but found in the CC fly midgut. Trypomastigot, it is an infective form of trypanosoma. The trypanosoma have the two species, Trypanosoma cruzii and Trypanosoma brucei. The disease caused by Trypanosoma cruzii is caused as Chagas disease or the South American trypanosomiasis. So you can see from the name South American trypanosomiasis, it is a common in the South America. And the Trypanosoma brucei, it causes the East African sleeping sickness and West African sleeping sickness. The East African sleeping sickness is from the Trypanosoma brucei rodentiens species, and West African sleeping sickness occurs due to Trypanosoma brucei gambiens. Trypanosoma cruzii occurs due to bite of the redweed bug, and the species of this bug is triatomine bug. Trypanosoma brucei occurs due to bite of CC fly. As these are not common in India, but still they are important from exam point of view. The life cycle is just not generally asked, but the clinical disease, you may get a short note on that. So, Trypanosoma cruzii, from the bite of the triatomine bug, it releases the metacyclic trypomastigot into the blood circulation. These trypomastigot transform into amastigot form, which is intracellular forms and dividing form. These amastigot will divide further, and some will transform into trypomastigot, come into the blood circulation again, and again the bug bites, and it will take the trypomastigot along with the blood meal. And in the bug, these trypomastigot transform into epimastigot and further divide, form the trypomastigot, and further may infect again a second person. So the infective form is a trypomastigot, which is present in the bug, and the diagnostic is also amastigot and tripomastigot in the peripheral blood cell. It produces the disease, Chagas disease, which can be acute form and the chronic form. At the site of the bug bite, there is a erythematous subcutaneous nodule which is called as chagoma, and it is a common on face. And a characteristic sign in acute chagomas is disease is Romana sign, which is a unilateral painless edema of eyelid and conjunctiva. Along with that, there is a generalized lymphadenopathy, hepatosplenomegaly, enlargement of liver and spleen, and severe myocarditis and meningoencephalitis occur. Most of the person resolves spontaneously in 4 to 8 weeks and or midway into chronic Chagas disease, which may last for years or decades. The person may be asymptomatic, and in that disease the parasite multiplies in skeletal and cardiac muscles and in GIT. From there may go to the systemic circulation in the cardiac muscles, leading to the cardiomyopathy, which alters the electrical conductance in the cardiac muscles, causing right bundle branch block, and in the blood it may cause thromboembolism. In intestine it may cause megaesophagus and megacolon, because increased distension of esophagus and distension of colon. The person may have difficulty in feeding, because there is a regurgitation of food whenever the person swallow. And in megacolon, the pain, distension of abdomen and constipation occurs. When the lung is involved, the muscles are involved, the action of the muscle will not be proper. So whenever the person tries to swallow something or drink something in megaesophagus, there is an aspiration of fluid into the lung, in the trachea, leading to the pneumonia, aspiration pneumonia. You can see the picture, the unilateral edema or puffiness of one eye, which is a characteristic sign in Chagas disease, Romana sign. And at the site where the bug bites, there is a chagoma. The diagnosis can be made by the blood smear. The peripheral blood is taken, and thick and thin smear can be made and stained with Jimsa and Leishman stain. Culture can be done, serology, PCR can be done, animal inoculation in mice can be done. Zero diagnosis is characteristic for the Chagas disease. In this, the bugs are allowed to feed on the blood of the patient, and later on, from the feces of these bugs, the infective form, Trypanosoma, is to be identified. Treatment is given as nitrofurantimox and benzidazole. The second species is a Trypanosoma brucei, which has the further two species, Trypanosoma brucei gambiens and Trypanosoma brucei rhodesiens. It causes the sleeping sickness or African sleeping sickness. Chagas disease is common in America and it is common in Africa. From its name, you can remember the epidemiology of that disease. It occurs due to bite of CC fly. The CC fly bites the human and it releases the trypomastigot into the blood circulation. These trypomastigot will further divide, multiply, binary fission. Whenever they come into the blood circulation and the CC fly bites again, trypomastigots are taken by the CC fry along with its blood meal. Then in the this fry, this trypomastigot will divide and transform into epimastigot, from epimastigot to further trypomastigot. So the infective form in this is a trypomastigot, and the diagnosis is trypomastigot in the blood. The disease produced by Trypanosoma brucei, sleeping sickness, it divided into two stages. Stage 1, when it doesn't involve the CNS, and the stage 2, when it involves the CNS and causes sleeping sickness. In the stage 1, there is a non-specific sign and symptoms, like the patient may have the fever due to dissemination of parasite through lymphatics and blood. The parasite will circulate on through the lymphatics and blood. There will be the lymphadenopathy. Especially the posterior cervical lymph nodes are involved, which are soft, rubbery and non-tender. And this posterior cervical lymphadenopathy, this is given as a characteristic name, winter bottom sign. The person have the generalized pruritus, macropapular rash with transient edema, and there is an enlargement of spleen and liver. And in blood, the person have anemia, leukocytosis, there is thrombocytopenia, polyclonal IgG production. Remember, there is a non-specific production of IgM. It is not specific to the parasite. In the second stage, there is an invasion of parasite to the CNS, and the person experiences the daytime somnolence with restlessness, which causes the daytime sleep to the person. That's why it is called sleeping sickness. And the person has listless gaze, delayed reflexes, abnormal sleep and tremor. Speech is abnormal. And whenever the CSF examination is done, the in CNS intracranial tension is raised, total protein content of CSF is raised, there is all the cells of the CSF are increased, and trypanosomes are seen in CSF. And a characteristic cell, abnormal plasma cells are seen in CSF, which have the large eosinophilic inclusion body. The treatment of stage 1 is with the pentamidine and soramine, and in the second stage, eflornithine and melarsoprol is given as treatment. Thank you. If you like this video, please comment, share with your friends. If you have any query, please ask in the comment box. Thank you.